Today we will learn how to use halving and doubling in multiplication. So the halving and doubling strategy for multiplication is one of the most fascinating multiplication strategies. Actually, the best part is that it actually is a strategy and not a trick. First, let us take a look at the halving and doubling strategy in action. To use halving and doubling, you simply halve one of the factors and double the other. Let us take an example. To solve 25 multiplied by 16, we could double the 25 to make 50. We will double 25, so double 25 is 50, and we will take the half of 16, that is 8. So then it will be easier to solve. Like this. So double 25, that is 50, and half of 16 is 8. So 50 times 8. So we can multiply 5 times 8. 5 times 8 is 40. Then so 50 times 8 is 400. We could actually take this one step further if we wanted to. By doubling the 50 to make 100 and halving the 8 to make 4. Like this. So first we have done, we doubled 25, so we got 50. We see half 16, we got 8. Again, if it is not easy for us, then we can double 50 to make it 100 and take the half of 8, that is 4. So 100 times 4, that is 400. So it will be more easier than the other one. Now we are left with 100 times 4, that is 400. It is essential to know why strategies work. Let us take a look at exactly why the halving and doubling strategy works. It's easiest to see this in an array like this. So here we have some blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks are there in one line. So how many 1, 2, 3, 4 rows are there? So here we have 4 times 5 array. And we know 4 times 5 is 20. So let us rearrange the blocks differently. So the block was arranged like this before. We have 4 times 5 array now. So let us rearrange it. So the same number of blocks we arranged like this. So in one line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are there. So there are 2 lines, 2 times 10. So do we still have the same number of objects? Yes, we have the same number of objects, here also 20 and here also 20. So they are just rearranged differently. Now we have a 2 times 10 array here. All we did was half the number of rows and double the number of objects in each row. So here there were 4 rows. So here we have 2 rows. So we took the half of 4. Half of 4 is 2. And here we had 5 blocks. We double the number 5. So we make it 10. So instead of 4 times 5, we take it. Half of 4 is 2. Then double 5 is 10. So 2 times 10. Does it always work? Halving and doubling will always work, but there are some situations that are better suited to it than others. Let us see. For example, let us take an example. 17 times 15. We want to use the same strategy in this. Technically, we could halve the 17 to make 8.5 and double the 15 to make 30. Okay, and it is not easy to multiply 8.5 with 30. So half of 17 is 8.5 and double 15 is 30. So always it is not easy to solve. So it does not make the problem easier to solve. Doubling and halving works best when one of the factor is even and when the other factor is a numbers like 5, 10, 25 or 50, then it is easier to solve by using this strategy. For example, doubling and halving would be an efficient strategy for 50 times 18. So here it is 50. We can double 50. We will get 100. And we can take the half of 18. We will get 9. Then we can multiply 100 times 9. That is 900. Let us take another example. 120 times 5. So here we can take the half of 120 and we can double 5. Okay, so take the half of 120. What is the half of 12? It is 6. So half of 120 it is 60. And so here we will double 5. Double 5 is 10. So 60 times 10, that is 600. It is easier to solve. Let us take another example. 25 times 20. So here we can double 25. Double 25 is 50. So and we can take the half of 20. Half of 20 is 10. So 50 times 10, that is 500. So always it is not easy to multiply, but now when one factor is 5, 10, 25 or 50 and the other factor is an even number, it is easier to use. Okay, thank you.